I'm going to tell you a little bit more about that in a minute, but for now, this song will tell you about all you need to know. This is called Tennessee Bound.
Chance to slow down. Wanna leave my past in my rear view. Wanna keep on driving till I can see you. Yeah, I'm a mama, Tennessee bound. Hey, hell, I'm a mama, ready for my brand new life. Get into an apartment, change my hair, no, I won't be thinking twice about the things I'm gonna miss. Cause it sure is really going out like this. So I'm in my mind, I'm ready for my baby.
This Friday with the announcement of the tour, we've got you on the bill. You're definitely sure you're coming, right? And I was like, yup. I guess I better get a visa for the UK. So I'm over here playing the songs I was playing in the bar that night that I met Ben, and this is one of them. This is called Praising God, Raising Hell. Who you want to be yet. You may have an inkling for it, but you know, you kind of go through a lot of processes to weed out what you're not first. And the hard thing about being in the industry is I was sort of around people that had an idea of what I should be and told me what to wear, how to sound, how not to sound, put down the guitar, all that kind of stuff. And I guess I kind of lost the reason that I loved music in the first place. So moving to Nashville for me wasn't just moving to Music City like we all want to do. It was kind of like a second chance to go, you know what? I love real, raw, honest music. You know, I want to write from experience and write from the real things in life. And hell, if five people like it, they're my five people and I'm going to keep writing for those guys, you know? And so the move to Nashville was a really special one for me. And this song was the first song, I guess, that I wrote about that whole part of my life. And I like to dedicate this song to anyone who's been through something in their lives that's kind of brought them out on the other side a little battered and bruised. And this one's called Damaged Goods.
I've been labeled, I've been called every name on bathroom stalls. Tried to fight every step, had a building on my bed. You tried to take me, shine me up, and fix all my broken stuff. All these years, I was never enough.
And this one time, I think it was just the straw that broke the camel's back a little bit. Poor guy. But I saw him coming up, and he was right there. I'm like, all right, here it comes. You know what's going to happen. Your eyes are looking around the corner. And he comes up and he goes, you're such a good girlfriend for putting up with all this guitar stuff. Does he at least let you go shoe shopping? I do like a good pair of shoes, don't get me wrong. However, I do like a great guitar. You know, it's just been something that I've been really drawn to for a really long time. And, you know, I'm going to apologize for that. But this one particular day, I think the guy saw the fire in my eyes and kind of backed away, like, okay, said the wrong thing to the wrong person. But I didn't let him have it. I went home. I went to the privacy of my own room, sat down, wrote a song about it, and now play it to thousands of strangers every night. So I want to dedicate this song to any girl out there who has a tough backbone. This one's called Mama Raised a Ramblin' Man. Editing before you even get a chance to sit and figure out how you're feeling. And this particular song was kind of the complete opposite of that. It was kind of hit me like a train, I guess. I was driving through Colorado on a bus. Have you guys been to Colorado? Anyone? Yeah? So you guys all know what's up. So I was driving through and I looked out the window and I saw these beautiful wildflowers on the side of the road. And it just really hit me, you know. I kind of started thinking about how beautiful things in life often be, you know, they're quite untouched, and that's kind of a good way to keep them sometimes. And I started to think about love too, and how no matter how long it's been, you know, it sort of doesn't go away for some people. And I started thinking about it, and this song really came out of nowhere, I guess. And this is called Wildflowers of Colorado. I'm sorry, it's late and you're crawling out, drowning like you do. I'm sorry, it's been a while that I was overthinking, like I.
So say you'll think of me when you see the wildflowers of Colorado. As far as your eye can see, like a smile for me that's lashing through the
so much. Well, this is going to be my last song, and I want you guys just to know how grateful I am for turning up early. You guys have been turning up early consistently every night, and it just goes to show how Shire's fans are such big music fans. So as a support act, I can tell you I'm very grateful that you guys are here right now. Shires too so much again for literally pulling me out of a bar. This has been a dream tour. This is, I think, night 21 of 22. Tomorrow night we wrap up in Basingstoke, and again, it's just been such a dream night after night. It's like a big family. We're all on the road and having a little too much fun. But it's just been amazing. So I want to thank them. I want to thank Nat, I want to thank Janie, Luca, all the guys for looking after me, Will, Mitch. You guys are amazing. They don't have to do it. They don't actually have to do my sound and lighting and everything like that, but this is additional work for them. So it's very well thanked, guys. I'm going to finish up with this song. All these songs are actually on a brand new record of mine that is out at the merch table. It's technically not out online until July, but I printed a bunch for the UK tour, and I just wanted to have a bit of a taste test over here and kind of share it here first before I let it out into the world. But this next song is one that I actually wrote the night before I went in to make the record. I was doing 10 songs in 3 days. At that point, actually, I was doing 8 songs in 3 days, and I was freaking out about it. I'm like, I'm a one-woman band playing every instrument. How the heck am I going to do this in 3 days? And it's like my brain has a sixth sense of humor, because as I'm driving my truck, I just started singing, "It's gonna be alright, it's gonna be alright," literally to calm myself down. And then I was like, oh, that's a good song idea. Damn it. So I stayed up late that night and started just kind of spouting out this song. And it was another one of those ones that just kind of came. And I got a bunch of my friends to come in and sing group vocals on it for me a couple of days later. And it turned into one of my favorite tracks on the record, actually, because it just became an affirmation that I needed, funnily enough. And so it's very easy to sing along to. It actually feels really nice to tell yourself it's going to be all right. So if you guys feel it towards the end, I'll give you a cue. Please don't leave me in the dark. My name's Sinead Burgess. I'm going to be out of the merch table after this. I'd love to meet you. I'm a big fan of your accent, so don't get too mad if I talk to you too much and try and get you to say a lot of fun words. Thank you so much. This is called Gonna Be Alright.
Bless my soul, I'm down again. Still out searching for a place called